Hey, brothers and sisters, this is Brother Patrick. I tried to start making a video giving people a word, and the Lord just arrested me. You know, I made a video of the word that the Lord gave me last night, and the Lord just has me on that same topic. I'm going to try to do the video with a prayer request. As you can see, I got my handwriting is so great. I got two sides there. Yes, I'm playing a little bit of music. The Lord is leading me because I've been doing it a little bit here and there. I've been trying to teach you guys how to worship the Lord. You want to get a hold of the Lord? You got to get out of your flesh. That's what this video is about. Getting out of your flesh. Let's start out right here. Every time I make a video, and in that video I made last night, I put a word from the Lord in there. The Lord gave me a prophetic word for the year 2014, or for now. Now. Revival first, then the rapture will happen. How long will be the revival? Will it be one day or 10 years? I don't know. I believe it'll be quick. I'll say that. I won't say 10 years, but say, will it be one day or 1 year, 2 years, 3 years? I don't know. That was a prophetic word. People can't stand sound doctrine. And this is a word from the Lord for you. And this is what the Lord just spoke to me. You think God don't know about pop culture and all that? The Lord said most of you guys who are running to and fro looking for a rapture date, you're Austin 3:16 instead of John 3:16. Now, I've never been wasn't a wrestling fan since I was a kid. When I was a kid, I used to believe in professional wrestling, I guess, till I was probably, 10 or 12 years old or whatever it was. But I have relatives who are really love wrestling, even though they're grown. And so I know about Steve Austin, and that's what the Lord is saying. They have his fans is carrying around signs. It says, the anointing from this song is just in my spirit right now. I am loved by God. This is my testimony. Listen, brothers and sisters, I just wanted to let that get on there a little bit. You know, God is using these things to melt your stone cold heart. Steve Austin's fans carry around a sign saying stone cold. You know, his nickname is Stone Cold Steve Austin. And his fans carried around a sign saying Austin 3:16. Blasphemy. Lots of you guys, it's not about blasphemy. For those who are in the flesh, they can't have an ear to hear. You're stone cold. You're at Austin 3:16 instead of John 3:16. Stone cold heart. There's others of you, those are the people that have zero spirituality. Cannot hear a word from God. They don't even know God. And then those of you who know the Lord, who can't hear a word, who can't get a hold of the Lord and get into the holy places I was talking about last night, to the Holy of Holies. I mentioned about how you spend all your time out at the. There's a group of people that spend all their time at the brazen altar, in the inner court. There's some of you who are stone cold and can't even understand what I'm saying. You never read the Bible. You have no idea what I'm talking about. You are stone cold. You are Austin 3:16. Those of you who are not Austin 3:16, but you're John 3:16, but you're not Acts 2:38. You haven't got through Acts chapter 2 yet. You come to that brazen altar and you see, as I mentioned, there are those who spend all their time there, like a sister I'm thinking of, I don't want to say where she's from. She spends all her time with a sin consciousness, obsessed about her sin. You'll never be perfect, but we repent. We don't live in sin, we repent and move on into the holy place, into the Holy of Holies. There's some of you on that side of the fence, you're stuck at the brazen altar, continually repenting, and don't go any further than the Lord. You're obsessed with offering sacrifices of repentance unto the Lord. But on the other end, which is lots of people, especially, coming out of the stone cold, out of the Austin 3:16 crowd, something I didn't mention last night. See, the Lord is like that. The Lord is building on what, right before I went to bed, I made this video. It was like midnight last night, 1 o'clock in the morning. I tried to do the words for people, but the Lord was arresting me. Wouldn't let me stop. So see, I got up. I put on my same shirt and got right here in front of the camera again because the Lord told me to. So the other group of people, those Stone Cold Steve Austin 316 people, when you come to the altar, you don't want to offer your sacrifice. You know, you're thinking about, hey, you know, I could use this this flesh for something else. And then even when the flesh is offered, when you crucify yourself with Christ, the Bible, Paul says, I am crucified with Christ. We're supposed to die daily. We're supposed to be with Christ on the cross. You know, our flesh is crucified with him. That's what, you know, and then we're buried with him and resurrected to become a new man. That's what baptism is all about. Behold, all things are new. Old things have passed away, the Bible says. The Bible also tells us that, you know, we're buried with Christ and resurrected with him. We become a new man in our new woman in Christ. But lots of you guys, you're still at that blazing altar and you're smelling that cooking meat, that flesh. You're loving that flesh so much. You can't resist the temptation of A, refusing to offer your sacrifice, the stone cold people. And then those whose idol is that flesh, they can't let it go. They keep looking at that cooking flesh. You know, there's some of the portions of the flesh when they sacrifice those animals. The Levites didn't work. The Levites were supported by those who came into the temple to offer sacrifices. So some of that meat went to them. You know, they're grilling it there too. You know, it's part of it. For the priests to eat while they're working in the temple. Now, there's some of that portions went to the priests and they took it home and ate it or whatever. But parts of it, they ate, you know, it was for the priests while they were in the temple. It was consecrated to them while they were working during their, they did a rotation. All men, I believe it's between the ages of 30 and 50 in the Levitical family. And then, of course, there's the different branches, the Kohens. They're the ones, you know, who actually work there in the temple area, the Kohens. And then, of course, the direct descendants of Aaron, could only his direct descendants can be the high priest. That's besides the point. All you guys who are obsessed about trying to follow the law in the Old Testament, all of you Judaizers, all of you who worship Israel as equal to God, and I know three or four different people who've told me that the Messianic rabbis were telling, some of them are saying that Israel is equal to God. When you say Israel, you're talking about God. I'm a big supporter of Israel, but there's people who make an idol out of it. Let me tell you something. In the Old Testament, as it says in Hebrews, we have a better covenant. In the Old Testament, only the high priest could go into the Holy of Holies. But in the New Testament, in Hebrews, as a matter of fact, it's in Hebrews chapter 12, it says, therefore we can come boldly before the throne of grace to obtain mercy. We can come boldly into the presence of the Lord. Why? Because of the blood of Jesus. Hallelujah. We are covered by the blood. Hallelujah. The blood of the Lamb. Hallelujah. 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 We are covered in the blood of Jesus. Now, those of you who have made it into the inner court, you made it past that brazen altar, you've ignored, you know, your heart's been melted, you exchanged Austin 316 for John 316, you came to that brazen altar, you did not become in awe of the sweet-smelling smell of the flesh. You did not hold back your sacrifice of praise unto our Lord and our God, our Savior, our Christ, our Deliverer, our Redeemer, our Savior, our King, our Lord, our Messiah, the Most Holy God, our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. You did not hold back from Him. You accepted His sacrifice for you. You repented of your sins, and you went on into the holy place. You found the showbread, the Word of God. You found the Holy Spirit. You discovered the Holy Spirit, the light of the world shining through our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. And now, through the church, Jesus told us to be salt and light. The Spirit of God is in us now, in the church age, coming from our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. He is the light of the world. We are His body. Do you understand the literal connection, the literal spiritual aspect? It's not just spiritual, but literally we are the body of Christ. When someone sees you, they're supposed to see Jesus. You're supposed to be salt and light, a reflection of our Master. That's why, if you think about it, the sun, S-U-N, represents the sun. the light of the world. And then in this parable I'm telling, in this metaphor, and the moon represents the church, the bride. We are a reflection of the sun. Brothers and sisters, we're supposed to reflect that light of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. Even though there's different meanings of these things, there's multiple meanings of everything, dualities and all that. I made tons of videos about all that. The devil's got all of his lies about the sun, moon, and stars and all that. But God said he set the signs in heaven for signs and seasons for people on earth to know. The gospel is in the stars too. That's the original intent of the different stars, of what people call the zodiac, these different formations of stars. That came from God for signs and for seasons to people. And then the devil has perverted it and corrupted it. But when you start hearing about how God uses the stars, that's the original. That's the John 3:16, not the Austin 3:16. That's the John 3:16, the original. I should even say that about this video. You know, John 3:16 is the original, and Austin 3:16 is the perversion of the things of God, the blasphemous perversion of the things of God. Stone cold satanic foolishness, perversion, twisted sisters, twisted brothers. Brothers and sisters, these kind of things, God even knows cultural things. God even knows these kind of things out there in the world, brothers and sisters. God even knows all of these things. Amen? God.